This is the strangest story that you'll ever hear. Unless you can't hear. In which case, this will be the weirdest tale that you've ever lived read.
I'll tell you the story of a dangerous man. Some say he was born with a gun in his hand. An only child and a motherless son. In his class, he was the difficult one.
He had a predilection for killing and hating. His name was an anagram of Satan. Bad attitude, bad blood, bad grammar. A man by the name of Stan. About a bad man, London.
A very bad man.
An evil man. His very name was a satanagram.
He's the kind of man who would walk around without any pants on and take a Viagra, just pop into town at the supermarket with an erection.
Man, he'd poke babies in the eye. Unrelated to the last bit. He'd steal your goat. You don't know what he would do with it.
Bad things.
You steal your Wi-Fi.
His name was a satanagram, just like Santa. But he was nothing like Santa. No, Santa's a wonderful man who brings presents, comes down your chimney and brings you presents. Whereas Stanner's a man who just comes down your chimney.
Why would someone do that? Ruin a lovely fireside evening.
Well, damn people, they were sick of him groping their goats and raping their sheep. One night, they drugged his drink. They tried to sneak out while he was asleep. But Stanner awoke before they got out of town, because the drug was just too weak. He gathered them round, shot every one of them down, right there in the street.
He shot everybody in the town down. And then you know what he said? He said, I'm out of this place. This town's dead anyway. He kind of did it like that with that head one. This town's dead anyway.
It's too soon, Stan.
That's real. What are you... He's literally adding insult to injury.
He put on his hat and got on his horse. Into a new town, he set his course. Went to a place to grab a bite to eat. Could not believe what he saw out on that street.
Outside where the wind blew in two directions, Stanner seemed to look at his own reflection. A man identical to imperfection. Same eyes, same lies, same size direction. Oh,
erection. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking he had a big one. No.
Oh, you thought because he's a bad boy, he'd have a big old one. Yeah. You thought he'd have a big, huge Rooney. No, London.
That's a rumor put out by bad guys.
Oh, yeah.
Give me all your money. When they come, you say I had a big one.
Well, I was just going to mention, you know who does have big ones as musicians?
Right. Well, they drew their guns both at once and aimed their shots directly. No one there had seen such a thing. Well, it's not what you'd expect to see. Bullets flew at the very same time on the very same trajectory. What I say is true, 'cause I was there and them bullets flew right next to me.
Stop right there as they met in the air. Then they fell to the ground without making a sound. Each man dropped his jaw and five more. Each pair of bullets did the same as before. They raised their brows as they saw the side of the bullets as they stopped each other's flight. And as though they were filled with pure elation, they began to laugh because it was quite a funny situation.
Funny situation.
Turns out this other guy's name is Anaz.
Two men couldn't shoot each other because they were absolutely perfectly matched in every way. So instead, they went to a cafe.
They started chatting, but turned out they had more in common than just physical appearances.
That's right. Very similar experiences. They'd done a lot of the same things. They loved the same kind of activities, like hurting people and maiming. They got on like a house on fire, which is also one of the first things they did together.
They both shared love for a predatory large cat.
You know, tigers, lions,
ocelots,
lynxes.
You have any big cats here in London? They're like big beavers.
They don't have beavers.
You guys don't have beavers. Why the fuck? Oh, badgers. That's what you guys
say. Badgers. That's what they are. Going out hunting for English beavers.
They became attached together like a brain and a tumor. Same taste, same hobby, same sense of humor. They bought a farm, started breeding puma. And they became lovers. Well, that's the rumor.
Well, that's what happened when Anats met Stana. But they say we all got our doppelganger. That might be false, but it might be true. Oh, what would you do if you met you?
That's the real question. What would you do if you met yourself, if you were confronted by your own person? Maybe you'd look at that other you in the eye and just think,
you'd walk up to that person and you'd hold them the way you've always wanted to be held, but no one's ever got it quite right. Sometimes I've done it too tightly, sometimes I've done it too loosely, with their arms all flopping like spaghetti dangling around. But this hug between you and that other you is a perfect consistency of hug.
There with your hands around yourself, you think, well, I wonder what my butt feels like. And you just like, you know, like spider walk one of your hands down to your other self's baton. And you give it a little squeeze and whoa, what's happening back there? The other you's doing the same thing. Hello. Is this wrong?
Then you wonder, I wonder if I'm a good kisser. So you kiss that other you. And you know what? Straight away, it feels right, it feels good. It feels like love.
They found a little love, an emotional connection to a very evil man with minuscule erections.
Stana and Anats, Anats and Stana, looking after each other now, looking after panthers.
They used to be murdering, 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 now they're cuddling, cuddling, cuddling.
Used to be threatening, 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 now they're getting big cats and petting them.
Used to be homicidal and killing, now they're in an homicidal chilling.
They used to be slaying and slaying and slaying, now they're gan and gan and gan, now they're in love.
Sorry about that. That was just far too long. That was...
It's like a whole show.
Yeah.
Tonight. It's gotten longer every night.